Hey, Grove Discovery Kids, I'm so glad you're joining us today. I hope that you had a great week and that you're ready to discover more about God. I have an amazing story to share with you today, but first, warm up your voices and let's worship together. That was so fun. Singing makes my heart so happy when I'm singing to God, but learning about God also makes me happy. Do you know what helps us learn about God? You're right, the Bible, God's Word. And whose words are in the Bible? God's words. It's God's words for us. God's Word tells us who He is, what He does, and how we can match our hearts with God's heart. I love God's Word, and I love learning about Him. Let's pray before we start our story. Heavenly Father, we thank You for this day. We thank You for Your Word and for the things that You teach us about You. God, help us to have listening ears and understand those things that are shared today. In Jesus' name, amen. I love being outside, and I bet you do too. And this week, it has been so hot that I wanted to go swimming. Did you get a chance to swim? Or maybe play in the sprinklers? That's the best. Hey, that reminds me of our story today. It's about a man named Jonah, one of God's really good friends, and he went for a swim in our story today, but it wasn't in a swimming pool. Let's check it out and see exactly what happened and where he went swimming. Our story starts with God coming to Jonah and telling him he had a big job for him to do. He told Jonah, "I want you to go to the city of Nineveh, and I want you to tell the people there that I have seen how wicked they have been behaving." Jonah said, "Yikes." Jonah didn't want to go to Nineveh. Those people were mean. But he went home and he packed his suitcase and he got all ready for the trip. But Jonah didn't go to Nineveh. Jonah bought a ticket to the city of Tarshish. Tarshish was this way, and God told him to go this way. It was in the opposite direction God had told him. He was running away from God. He wasn't obeying him. Jonah's plan didn't sound like a good plan to me. Did it to you? Well, I can tell you, it wasn't. So this is what happened. Jonah bought his ticket, got on the ship for Tarshish, and they began to sail. But God sees everything that we do and everywhere that we are. And he saw that Jonah was not going to Nineveh. And so God sent a storm, a terrible storm. The wind was blowing so hard that the sails on the ship were all over the place. And the rain was pouring down on the ship, and the waves were crashing against it, and water came up over the top of the ship and covered the floor. The sailors were terrified. They thought for sure they were going to die. Where was Jonah? Jonah was down below, and he was sleeping in his cabin. The captain went down and shouted at Jonah. He said, "What are you doing? Don't you see that we might die? Why aren't you praying to your God? All the other sailors are praying to their gods." They weren't the one true God, though, that Jonah knew. And so Jonah knew right away, "You guys, you need to throw me over. This storm, it's my fault. I tried to run away from God, and so you need to throw me over." And they're like, "Whoa, no, we can't do that. That's not the right thing to do, and we don't want your God mad at us." Jonah said, "It's the only way that this storm is going to stop." And the storm was getting worse and worse, and so they finally agreed that they must throw him over. And so they took Jonah and they threw him into that raging sea. And immediately, as soon as they had done that, the wind stopped, the waves stopped, and the sea was all calm again. But Jonah was sinking deeper and deeper into the water. He must have surely thought he was going to die. But God was watching out for Jonah, and God was going to keep him safe. He sent this big, big fish that came and just swallowed Jonah up, and he went right into the belly of that fish. And for 3 days and three nights, Jonah sat in that belly of the fish. And he thought and he thought and he prayed and he prayed, "God, I am so sorry that I didn't believe you. I didn't follow you. I didn't obey what you told me to do. But God, I know I want my heart to match your heart, and so I will do what you tell me to do." Well, God was watching, and he saw Jonah and heard Jonah. And so he commanded that fish to spit Jonah out, and just like that, Jonah was on dry land. And God came once again to Jonah, and he said, "Jonah, I need you to go to Nineveh and tell the people that I have seen how wicked they are. And in 40 more days, their city is going to be destroyed." This time, Jonah obeyed. He got to Nineveh. Nineveh was huge. It was so big. It took him 3 days just to go to every part of the city. But he told the people in every area he went to, "God sees what you are doing, and he is not happy with how unkind and wicked you are being, that your heart doesn't match his heart, that you are going in a different direction, and he loves you, and he wants you to love him too." And so he went from one area of the city to the other until everybody in the city of Nineveh knew that God was unhappy with their wickedness. When the king heard it, the king commanded everybody, "Everyone is to pray to Jonah's God, and everybody needs to turn from their wrong ways and do what is right." And so the people did. They prayed and they asked God to forgive them. And they told him that they want to follow him and to love him. And when God saw and heard what the Ninevites said, God decided not to destroy the city. Boys and girls, God wants us to love and obey him. He wants our hearts to match his heart as well. God wants us to obey him and to love him and to follow him. And we can do that by being kind to others. We can do that by helping our brothers and sisters. We can show our love by being obedient to our moms and dads and to our teachers. And most of all, we'll know when we love God by matching our hearts with His heart, when we say we're sorry and we ask forgiveness for those wrong things that we have done. Got your thinking caps on? What happened to Jonah when he disobeyed God? That's right, he was in a storm and he got thrown overboard deep into the sea. That's right, boys and girls, good listening. How did God keep Jonah safe for those 3 days and 3 nights? Do you remember what happened as he was sinking? Oh, you were good listeners. That's right, God sent a fish, and that fish swallowed Jonah up and kept him safe for 3 days and 3 nights. Why did God decide not to destroy Nineveh? Do you remember why God didn't destroy them? Oh, you're right, because they prayed and asked forgiveness, and God forgave them. I have some papers, like we always do, for you to do so that you can share them with mom and dad and with your friends and family. This one is a picture of Jonah getting tossed over the boat, and look who's waiting for him, the fish that God sent to keep him safe. And then we have an activity for you. Whoa, that looks like a big fish, doesn't it? This is really fun. Have mom and dad fold this for you and you can open it up and there's Jonah. Isn't that a fun surprise? So this is for you to do as well. Boys and girls, thank you for joining us today. I look forward to seeing you next week. Be blessed. Bye-bye.